Good morning, my dear students. Let us discuss about corporate legal framework, unit 2, class 9. Today's our concept is rights of an unpaid seller under the Sales of Goods Act. Coming to the diagram of rights of an unpaid seller, here unpaid seller, there is a contract between party A and party B. Party A sold some goods towards to the party B, but party B did not completely paid amount to goods towards party A. So here party B duties are pending. So party A seller is called as a unpaid seller. When he became an unpaid seller, party A is having some rights of an unpaid seller. Here rights of an unpaid seller is divided into two important categories. Those are against the goods and against the buyer personally. Coming to the against the goods, again it is divided into two different categories, where the property in the goods has passed to the buyer, or where the property in the goods has not passed to the buyer. Coming to the first category, it is containing three different type of rules. Those are right of line and right of stoppage in transit and right of resale. Coming to the second category, also containing four different rights. Those are withholding delivery, second one line and stoppage in transit, and fourth one resale. And main second category is against the buyer personally, containing three different rights. Those are suit for price, suit for damages, suit for interest. Coming to the rights of an unpaid seller under the Sales of Goods Act, as per section 2 of F of Indian Contract Act, the seller must transfer the goods sold and buyer must pay the required amount in return under the contract of sale by them. This is known as reciprocal promise. Here there is a contract between party A and party B. Party A selling the goods to the party B, and party B is buying the goods from party A, and party A has completed their duties from their side, and party B also completed their duties from their side. Here both sides of the duties are completed, rules and rights are also completed. So then it is called as a reciprocal promise. There are three important rights of an unpaid seller against the goods, that is rights of line and rights of stoppage of products in transit and rights of resale. Rights of line and rights of stoppage of the products in transit and rights of resale. Coming to rights of line, according to section 47 is, here line is the right to keep possession of the products and refuse to give purchaser until the fee is paid by the purchaser. And an unpaid seller in possession of the products is entitled to work out his line on the products. Here there is a contract between two parties, party A and party B, and that is nothing but seller and buyer. Here seller has sold the products towards party B, that is buyer, but buyer has paid half of the amount towards the purchasing of the products. Now half of the amount still is pending. Now complete rights is not given to party A or party B. Still the ownership rights are belonging to the party A. Now party A is having the some special right, that is rights of lien. Rights of lien. What is the meaning of rights of lien is, that is legal rights, and there he is having the claiming chance. He is having the temporary rights regarding ownership of the goods, that is possession of the products. He want to protect the products Possession is nothing but authority and power and ownership rights of the products temporarily. Until the party B want to clear the Jew from party A, then and up to then, party A is having the rights on that products. When the party B has completed his due, then immediately the ownership rights is transferred from party A to party B. In the case of purchaser insolvency, the line exists even though goods were offered on credit and the duration of credit has not expired till the time. If before payment buyer turns insolvent, the seller is entitled to exceed his rights and hold the product as security for the charge. Here there are two different cases. In the first case, the purchaser is in the state of insolvency. Here in the first case, the purchaser in insolvency, the line exists even though goods were offered to the credit and duration of the credit has not been expired till the date. Here there is a contract between party A and party B. Party A decided to sell the goods to the party B. There is a contract is happened, but there is a duration time is there, credit time is also not expired, but the party B is in the position of insolvency. Party B is in the position of insolvency. Due to this reason, the unpaid seller having rights to stop the transfer of the goods towards him. And coming to the second case, if before payment the buyer turns into insolvent, the seller is entitled to exceed the rights and the hold the products as security for the charge. In second case, the payment is did not started till now, then party B is in the position of insolvent. He is turning into insolvent position. Then the seller is entitled to exceed his rights. He can have the some special rights that to hold the products as a security for the charge. And coming to the third category of example is the unpaid seller line is a possessory line. The unpaid seller line is a possessory line. Here line is nothing but legal right and claiming and temporary power. The legal rights and temporary powers main reason is to protect the products here and may be exercised so long as the seller stays in ownership of the products. Here when the line is supported to the seller, he will become a ownership of the products until the party B want to completed his due towards party A. He will be, then only the transfer of ownership will convert to the party B in this case. He may exercise his rights offline, but he is holding the ownership of the goods as agent for the customer according to section 47 of 2. And any property in transfer of files identify that the products which are not affecting these rights supplied the goods should stay inside real possession of the seller. Here there is a case between party A and party B. Is nothing but party A transferring to the goods towards the party B and party B getting the goods, but party B did not completed their duty, payment duty. So the goods are stay inside in the real position of the seller. So the transferring of the goods is stopped. Now even though the party B has paid some amount towards goods, also complete ownership not at all changed towards party B. So still party A is having the some possession, that is nothing but some authority, temporary power, temporary rights, that is line rights, legal rights. And in truth, when belonging has passed to the consumer, then the most effective maintenance of the product is technically known as lien. Here, in second case, the goods is transferred to the party B, that is consumer. Then most effective maintenance of the product is technically known as lien. Now party B is having the legal rights to maintenance of that product because of delivery is completed. And it is not at all a complete ownership. So we want to identify this one. and third example, in which the belonging goods have not exceeded the customer possession and the same remains with the seller, then it will be very difficult to maintain that the seller has aligned towards his own goods. Here, party A and party B are there. Party A seller the goods, party B buyer the goods, but still party B want to pay the some amount of money, but customer did not having rights on the goods because he did not get him the goods in possession. So possession rights, legal rights are temporary rights are protection rights of the products are still in the hands of seller only. The seller line, when an asset has not exceeded, the purchaser is called as a right of withholding shipping. Here, the seller line, when an asset has not exceeded, the purchaser is called as a right of withholding shipping. Here, still the seller is having rights to withholding the shipping rights also. For that reason, section 46 of 2 states that in which the belonging goods have not handed over to the customer, the unpaid seller has to right to withhold the transfer. When the second party did not pay money completely, the first party is having the rights to stop the transfership of ownership and transfership of goods also. And the seller may additionally incurring from storing the products inside and the exercise of his line for the child. Due to party B only, party A is storing the products and some burden is he is feeling. After completing contract, this amount, this charge should be burdened by the party B only in particular cause. The rights of line extends to entire product on his own despite the fact that part price of our once item has already been made. In other phases, the consumer is not entitled to claim delivery of a part of the products. Here there is a contract between party A and party B. Party A want to deliver the products to the party B. This is a one big machinery item. It is containing several components in it. Here the delivery of the product is done. Here no need to deliver of individual component material of that product. So here we want to claim for only product for delivery purpose. Here the consumer is not entitled to claim delivery of a part of products. And coming to the second example, in addition, wherein an unpaid seller has made component shipping of the goods, he also exercised the rights of align on the rest, except such element shipping has been made under such instance as to reveal an agreement to waive the line, section 48. In this case, the one of the good is transporting towards from party A to party B. It is in the position of components, number of components. So here everything is mentioned in that contract. There is not at all a problem. Here we want to follow up the rules and regulations from section 48 of Indian Contract Act. And also the line can be exercised even though the seller have received a decree for rate of products. What do you mean by decree? Decree is nothing but official order or force of law or temporary power which is given by authoritative or judicial department. Here waiver decree is nothing but official order or force of law temporary power which is given by authoritative or judicial system. For the rate of products, here line power is having towards the party A until the party B want to complete its duties. It is notable here court is giving the some additional power to the party only under section 49 of 2. When is liney lost? When the liney rights are lost by party A is, as already discovered, line relies upon physical ownership of the products. As soon as possession is misplaced, the line is also misplaced. The unpaid dealer of the goods loses his line. Here party A and party B are there. Party A is transferring goods to the party B, and physical owner of the goods is now party B. When he became the physical owner completely, then party A will lose the partial rights, that is line's rights. Rights of stoppage of goods in transit. Rights of stoppage of goods in transit. The rights of stoppage in transit method is rights of stopping the transit of goods, even if they may be with a carrier, for the cause of transmission to the buyer. Here the right of stoppage in transit method is right of stopping the transit of the goods, even if they may be with a carrier, of for the cause of transmission to the buyer. Here there is a contract between party A and party B. Party A sold the goods to the party B, and party B has paid some amount of money, but complete money is not at all paid. Now party A is having rights to stop the transportation of goods towards the party B. That is called rights of stoppage of goods in transit. And resuming the ownership of customer and retaining the protection until they made payment of goods. Here the person who needs the ownership of the goods, they want to pay remaining the money. When the party B paid remaining money only, immediately party A will deliver those goods to the party B, then the problem will solved. And hence the right is extension of right of line, because it entitles the seller to regain ownership even if the seller has parted with the possession of the products. Here the right is an extension of a right of line, and because it entitles seller to regain by help of rights of stoppage of the goods only, the seller will have rights of ownership even if he seller the has parted with the possession of the products. Even he sell the goods towards the party B also, he did not completed a duty. So when the party A has applied rights of stoppage, he will get the ownership rights also temporary. Until party B completed their duties, party A only owner of that goods. He want to protect the goods. And when can this right be exercised? An unpaid seller can exercise this right in simplest way then when means the purchase become insolvent. The buyer is said to be a bankrupt when he has denied paying his debits inside the normal route of business, or if he cannot pay his money, then he will be due according to section 28. Here there is a contract between two parties, party A and party B. Here party A is ready to sell the goods and party B is not ready to purchase the goods because he is in the position of insolvency. Due to this reason, according to section 28, according to section 2 of 8, the seller is having rights to stop the goods transportation towards B because of party B is in the position of insolvency. And the property has exceeded the buyer. If estate have not surpassed the buyer, then this right is called right of withholding shipping. Here the completed power is not at all given to the party B because he was off paid only. He is off owner only. But when he completed his duties, until then the owner of assets are right of suppressed, right of withholding and shipping. All duties are belongs to the party A only according to section 46 of 2. The products are within route of transit. Here the products are within route of transit. The products, this means the goods should be neither with the seller nor with the buyer, nor with the agent. Here this means the products are within route of transit, means the products are in the transportation process. This means the goods should not be with seller or with buyer or seller agent or buyer agent. and the product has to be within custody of carrier as an intermediary. The products are should be within the custody of carrier as an intermediary. At the time, carrier needs to be either a seller agent or customer agent. Because if he is a seller agent, then the products are still in the arms of seller in eye of regulation, and consequently there may be no transist. And if he is the customer agent, the consumer gets transportation, the attention of law. Hence, quarry of stoppage does not rise up here. So the products are in the transportation process. The products are not at all with the seller or buyer or seller agent or buyer agent. The products are with some intermediary carrier of custody. Duration of transit according to section 51. Since the right of stoppage in transit can be exercised simply as long as goods are inside the route of transit, it becomes important for seller to recognize the transit route, where it starts and where it comes to destination. Here, since the right of stoppage is transit can be exercised simply as long as goods inside the route of transit. Here, the seller is knowing where the goods are there, means where it is starting, where it is ending. No total grip of the seller is having on the goods. That is called, it become an important for seller to recognize the transit route, starts and where it's come to destination. And when the transit involves a stop, the right of stoppage cannot be exercised. When a transit involves a stop, the right of stoppage cannot be exercised. When previously party A involves to stop the transit, then he is not having the right to stoppage, can't be exercised. Without starting the process, how can he stop? That is called duration of transit right, section 51. And items are deemed to be in course of transit from the time when they are added to a service or other bailey for motive of transmission to the buyer till the purchaser or his agent takes transport of them. Here, until the buyer is receiving the goods, till party A is having the rights on that particular transportation of goods. Thus, the transit continues as long as the products aren't delivered to the customer or his agent. Here, there is a special condition. When the transit is deemed to be near to the destination, when the goods are very near to the destination, then the seller cannot exercise his right to stoppage in following situation instances. When the goods are near to delivery destination place, then seller cannot exercise for right of stoppage rule in following instances, in following situation. Coming to the situation, there are the four different situations. Those are, products have reached the destination. When products are reached the situation, immediately party A won't have right of stoppage rule. And when the buyer or his agent obtain the delivery of goods before they arrive at the appointed destination, before the destination only, in the middle only, buyer or buyer agent is went to receive the goods, then also the party A is not having the right to stoppage. And in third case, while the products have arrived at the destination and the seller acknowledges to the consumer or his agent and he holds the products on his behalf of, when the goods are delivered at the destination place, even though the consumer or his agent that he holds the products on his behalf of, he will lose that stoppage right also. And coming to the fourth situation, when the products have arrived at the destination, then the customer, in preference to shipping, request the seller to hold the products to some further destination, then the seller agrees to take them to the new destination. In this case also, the seller cannot have the right to stoppage of the goods. When the service wrongfully refuses to supply the goods to the consumer agent when some part of shipping of the goods have been made to customer with intention of handing over the whole of the products, transist can be acquitted for rest of the products also. How is the right stoppage exercised? The unpaid seller may additionally exercise his right of stoppage in transist mode. How? Right stoppage exercised according to section 52. The unpaid seller may additionally exercise his right of stoppage in transist mode through taking real possession of the goods. When the other party is taking the real authority of the goods, the party A will lose the right to stoppage, and by means of giving declaration to seller in whose possession of the goods are, such votes can be given to the person in real ownership of the goods. Within the latter case, the board must accept well in advance to permit the superior to talk together with his agent or servant in time for transport to the customer. Here, such votes can be given to the person in real ownership of the goods. Within the latter case only, the board must accept well in advance to permit superior talk together with his agent or servant in time for transport to the customer. And if with the addition of the mistake he offers the products to purchaser, he may responsible for the conversion. The fee of redelivery are to be tolerated by seller. Rights of resale. The rights of resale is a completely valuable right given to an unpaid seller when, within the absence of this right, the unpaid seller other rights in opposition to the goods. Specially, line and stoppage in the transit could not longer have been used due to the fact this right only entitled unpaid dealer to keep the product until paid with the aid of the buyer. Here, right of resale means there is a contract between two parties, party A and party B. Party A has sold the goods to the party B, but party B did not completely payment fully towards party A relating to the goods. But here we are having the two rights, right to lien or right to stoppage in goods transit. And third one is right of resale. In the first two cases, we will have the some doubts to stop. But coming to the rights of resale, we will have the complete ownership rights. When we have in the right of resale, immediately the party B will completes his due and he will receive the goods. Otherwise, we are having right to resell the goods because ownership rights is not at all transferred to the party B. Still now, ownership of the goods is party A only. If customer maintains to stay in default, should the predicted price maintained in order to retain the goods independently, especially while products are perishable? In the case of products are perishable, if any loss is happening, then the immediately party A can resell the goods towards to other because of the products are perishable. Then party A will have a legality support to resell. And largely, this cannot be aimed for the Regulation Act according to Section 54. Therefore, offers to the unpaid seller a confined right to sell goods inside following lines. According to this situation, resale can be done by the party A. Goods are perishable in nature. First case. Coming to second case, in case the buyer needs to make a default. Make a default is nothing but failure. In second party is failure to buy. In that case also, first party can buy the needs and resell these products to another party. Because of here, second party is failing to purchase the goods. And coming to the third party, Customer does not pay the price with an affordable time. In this case, party B did not pay an amount towards to party A in given time period, affordable time period. Due to this reason also, time lapse and the money is still pending in process. Due to this reason also, party A is having right to resell the products to some other party. This is about the rights of unpaid seller. Thanking you, my dear students. Please subscribe my YouTube channel.